In science, it's important to have quantifiable data. How bright is that star? How strong is that force? How smelly is that fart? Hey everyone, Julian here for DNews. I know it seems like a juvenile topic, but flatulence is a part of everyone's lives, and it actually can tell you some interesting things about yourself. So today, with as much maturity and aplomb as I can muster, we're gonna talk about booty toots. First of all, it may surprise you to learn that gut gas contains information about your health. For example, if you have lactose intolerance, it's because your body no longer produces an enzyme that breaks down the sugars in milk. Your gut bacteria, on the other hand, love that stuff and will munch it up, leaving you uncomfortable and passing the wind of Satan. Or in rare cases, those bacteria that are supposed to be in your large intestine gets into your small intestine and thrive, eating nutrients that are supposed to go to you and making you gassy and bloated in the process. A bleeding ulcer will cause foul-smelling stool and flatus, and an excess of hydrogen sulfide, the molecule responsible for that rotten egg smell, may be a sign of a damaged gut lining, inflammatory bowel disease, or even, in severe cases, colon cancer. So if you have a really rank stank, can't hurt to see a doctor. But even if you're healthy, you probably don't fart daisies and rainbows. And that's because of that gut bacteria. They munch on the undigested nutrients on the way to your colon, but the odorous molecules in their waste gas make up less than 1% of a fart. When you smell a fart, you're basically like a shark detecting tiny amounts of blood in water, except with farts. Thanks, nature! Many of the stench offenders are sulfur-based, and a prime source of sulfur in a diet is from meat products. There's also scatol, which mammals produce from tryptophan, and it smells like scat. Though, weirdly, it's also made by some flowers, so roses don't really smell like poo-poo, but some lilies do. Vegetarians, that doesn't mean your farts don't stink. Sulfur is also found in broccoli, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, cabbage, almonds, and dried fruit. And while a vegetarian's careless whispers may be less odorous, they will likely be more frequent due to a high-fiber diet that makes gut bacteria thrive. What isn't made by bacteria is surprisingly similar to air, which makes sense considering you swallow air when you eat. Typically, farts are 59% nitrogen, 21% hydrogen, 9% carbon dioxide, 7% methane, and 4% oxygen. None of that actually smells. People tend to think methane is the culprit because natural gas leaks have a distinct smell. Natural gas leaks in your home, I mean. That one wasn't a fart euphemism. But methane is odorless. Commercial natural gas has an artificial smell added, so you know when to not light a match. So, if farts can actually tell you all this useful stuff about your health, how do we capture one and measure its composition? According to Peter Gibson at Monash University in Victoria, Australia, we can either measure what your farts are made of by fermenting your poop or capturing your breath, because the gases in your gut get reabsorbed into your blood and can wind up in your mouth. That's right, you all have fart breath. On a less serious note, in 2009, Cornell University seniors Robert Klein and Miguel Salas designed a machine that was an unholy combination of a thermometer, microphone, and hydrogen sulfide detector. When someone tests the device, it combines information from the three sensors to rate the sample on a scale of 0 to 9, 9 being what I can only assume is a perfect fart. It's totally normal to pass gas, yet many people are self-conscious and hold it in. But can that kill you? Nah, but it can harm you in other ways, though. Tara has more here.
So is holding them in bad for you? Well, yes and no. It's not gonna kill you, but it will make you uncomfortable and it can exacerbate certain health issues. When we hold farts in, the gas retreats back into our body and gets absorbed into the intestinal walls where it eventually mixes in with our blood.
So, do you fart? Keep in mind, if you say no, you're a dirty, dirty liar, pants on fire, and that's dangerous because that methane is flammable. Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I will see you next time on DNews.